Hi, and welcome to this segment of RRR Tool Solutions tool demonstration videos. We want to talk about our frame kit today. This is specifically designed for the CB750 Honda, a single overhead cam produced from 1969 through 1978. Fits the K models and the F models. The ideal is that Honda put a dry sump engine, 736 cc's, into the CB750 Honda. And when they did that, their intention was not that this would be serviced in the frame. There's literally a quarter inch of clearance between the frame rails that are originally there and the top of the engine cover. The only way to get these covers off is to unbolt the right side, pull this engine completely out of the frame, lifting it up and clearing the sump. To alleviate that, a lot of drag racers and builders throughout the years would cut away their frame and leave just simply one backbone going from front to back. I never felt comfortable with that and certainly wouldn't condone it. So what I did when I did my 750 Honda back in 2006 is I came up with a way of replacing the missing rails. You can do that by using our frame kit, which incorporates part of the triangulated brackets that come with the frame. These are simply cut off halfway up to the upper neck backbone. We use joints. These are very robust, very heavy duty half joints. This is a 180,000 PSI oilman rod that has a 180,000 PSI tensile strength. Hardened rod, it goes into this insert 1.1 inches and is threaded and kept in there with Loctite. These joints fit together with grade 8 hardware. These button heads make simple work of holding these fasteners together. There is a little bit of clearance in here left here for powder coat or paint. This is made to be a very tight fit, very strong, very durable. I've been asked many times what the strength of this joint system is as compared to the thin wall tubing. I'm quite sure that this tubing would bend like spaghetti before we ever damaged one of these inserts. I've got this separated to show you a couple of things. One, you're going to get a grade 8 jam nut in here. This is a 7/16-20. It's a grade 8 hardware. This is not for adjustability. What this is for is to simply, we'll put it on here, I'll show you. This is a blind insert. This insert is fully threaded. Again, this is slightly over 1 inch. This is fully threaded and is welded up into the inside of the front rails. Very important to follow that, because what this allows, and this is welded in this area right here, what this allows is removal of this cylinder head cover and the cylinder head so that you can get to the pistons and the rings and the valve train and so forth, as well as once that material is removed, getting the whole engine out is a whole lot easier. But this does allow for in the frame building and servicing of internal components, otherwise not possible on the 750 Honda. Very important, these blind inserts are there so that when these are threaded in, and I'll show you the importance of that. As you see, that assembled piece literally will unbolt and leave this whole area free. All right, what we've done here, again, we've turned this on the side so you can see it. Very important that you see the clearance. But we've gone in and simulated the fact that we've welded in the blind joints, which again, you saw the threaded 7/16-20, 180,000 PSI oil rod used, inserted 1.1 inches down into the joint. This is a solid steel billet joint. You've seen us go in there, and the importance of that is that this section, along with the threaded rod, will completely unscrew, given unrestricted access for the cover and the cylinder head to come up through the frame. The other thing is we went ahead and simulated the welding in of the back joints. Again, this is necessary so that these are stay fixed. We're going to put this all back together so that we can now have a rigid frame and again replace the structural integrity. So what we'll do here is we will and there's two bolts on each joint. Again, these are grade 8 bolts. You can torque these down to 14 foot-pounds. I would encourage you to use a locking agent such as a Loctite glue, medium strength. That's what I use. Now, this is a demonstration model. Obviously, the factory piece would have another triangulated piece here to hold that together. You'd be dealing with a single bracket. This was a demonstration only to show how the joints went together. I'll show you again on this side, region over, how easy this was. One of the things we'll show you here in just a minute, the reason this was done this way will be very obvious. One, we wanted a very strong joint with a lot of integrity. Two, we wanted this to be completely invisible, such that once assembled and put on the motorcycle and the gas tank return, this would not be visible from the side, from anywhere, even somebody looking for any modifications and so forth. Our repairs would not be able to see it. That is the kit installed. We have this bracket here. You would come in and you would bolt from the top and bottom so that you tie that triangulation back in together. We're using grade 8 bolts for this. And there's two of those supplied for each kit. I'm going to turn this around so that you can see how well and how that fits back into the frame. One of the things I want to show you is how this kit integrates with the factory frame in either a restored, heavily modified, custom build. One of the most important criteria of this kit was strength, the second being absolutely invisible to the naked eye. And you'll notice there that the fuel tank completely covers it. The stock ignition switch can be mounted where it goes, and no part of this can be seen unless you actually get up under the bike and look at it from the bottom side up, and that was the design goal. Even up here in the front where this gap is between the tank and the frame, all of that is the stock frame. The insert, the blind insert welds to the back side of that switch. This footage shows the bike inside of the bike, and again, complete concealment under the tank, between the seat and the tank is completely maintained. The kit is installed from this point to about this point, showing this area right here, which either with the seat up or looking from the front can easily be seen.